John, God said we should not shave, clean shave our beard. You acknowledge that? Then you should use razor and shave your head, like what Asafa Powell and those other big man doing today. It is right, like Desmond Mackenzie. God said we must not do that. You understand? We must not do that. Give me Deuteronomy 22 verse 5. Sister, this one is for the sisters as well. Because you are the senior sisters. You should be instructing the younger sisters. You understand? Read that one for me.
The book of Deuteronomy 22 verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
What is it our sisters is wearing today that pertain to man? Can any one of you answer that?
Pants.
Is pants made for women? Why is it that our sisters now dressing in pants? What? So what about those who don't have any work? Listen. You hear what God said about that? Read that.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So is it okay for a woman, for a man to be wearing a woman's garment? It is abomination unto the Lord thy God. You understand? So when you're in an abomination, give me in Proverbs chapter 28. Hold on. Let's find out when you're in abomination, because we're in sin and we quickly call upon God whenever there's some issue that arises. We quickly call upon God. Let's find that out. Proverbs 28. Give me verse 9. 28 and verse 9.
Proverbs 28, verse 9. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination.
So, if the Lord said that you must not be wearing pants, women, and you kiss it 2 times and says, my clothes, my woman, I'll wear. God said even your prayer is abomination to him. Do you understand that? Give me John chapter 9 verse 30, 31. Right? God said even your prayer is abomination. God don't want to hear that. Do you understand? So even when you're going through hell and you're crying now, God don't want to hear your prayer. Because what? You are rebellious. You're hard head. You're stiff neck. You don't want to hearken to God's word. Read that for me.
Book of John 9, verse 21. Now we know that God heareth not sinners, but if any man be worshipper of God and do it his will,
do what?
Do it his will.
God said that. Now you know, brother, now you know, sisters, that the Lord God heareth not sinners, but they that do his will. Read on.
Him. He here.
That's who God hear. Give me the will of God in Psalms. That's who God hear. Those that will the will of God. You understand? You Israelites, you willing to do the will of God? Let's get it.
Book of Psalms, chapter 40, verse 8. I delight to do thy will, oh my God.
This is our forefather David. David said, I delight to do your will, oh my God. You willing to hear the will of God? Very good. Read.
Yeah, the law is within my heart.
What is the will of God? What is the will of God? The laws of God. That is the will. David said, read it again.
I delight to do thy will, oh my God. Yeah, thy law is within my heart.
Thy law is within my heart. You understand? So therefore, it is for you to keep God's commandments. It is for you to keep God's commandments. Because God only gives the commandment to you, the Israelites. Give me Psalm 147, 19 and 20. God only gives you the commandment to keep. He didn't give it to your so-called white friend. He didn't give it to your so-called Chinese friend. He gave it to you, the Israelites. Okay? That's why they can't do anything and still alright. Psalm 147, verse 19 and 20.
Yeah.
157:19-20.
Psalms 147:19. He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
You hear that? You hear that? Who did he give you word to? And who is Jacob? Very good. Read on.
Verse 20. He has not pierced you with any nation.
What does he like there?
He has not dealt so with any nation.
He has not dealt so with any nations. As I mentioned a while ago, they are not commanded to keep the Sabbath day. That's why they are out here buying and selling out here. It is your responsibility to do so. Do you understand? It is you. Give me Acts chapter 3 verse 18 there. It is your responsibility. You understand? Acts chapter 3 verse 18.
Acts 3 verse 18. But those things which God before has shown. Acts 3 verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted.
My brother, my sisters, do you hear what God said a while ago? Read it again for them.
Acts 3 verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted.
You hear what God said? Repent ye therefore and be converted. So now my next question to you now. You are in the church. How do you become converted? How can you become a convert? Where's the system?
Word, believe, and turn from your sins.
You say, hear the word, believe, and turn from your sins, and you say, baptize. Give me Psalms chapter 19 there for me, verse 7. We're going to show you. Yes, sister, you're not wrong, but let's see what God said. Remember, if any man speak, let him speak from what? The oracle of God. So therefore, we're going to remain in the word of God. Let's get that one first.
Psalm 19, verse 7.
My sister, let me ask you, my brother. What is sin? What is sin?
Transgression of the law.
Say it again.
Transgression of the law.
Sin is a transgression of the law. So how is it that it was taught to us in the church that God laws are done away with? When sin is a transgression of the law. So what is now? I used to go to church. And I was taught that God loves everybody. Is that so?
Yeah.
What's that?
Yeah. Alright, bro.
Oh, come on, sister. Oh, come on, sister. Come on, sister. Let's go again. You said, what you said? You said God loves everybody. What does God say?
Jacob I love, but Esau I hate.
Oh. So who is Esau? Who is Esau? What's up?
White people.
Something well on, man. Hold on. When I get some teaching somewhere, you know. When I get some edification somewhere. So if Esau is the right person, is it okay for you to marry to them? That is what?
That's an intermarriage.
That's an interracial what?
Intermarriage.
Interracial marriage. Is that a sin? Is that a sin?
Yeah.
It's a sin. Read it for me. Very good.
1 John 3:4. Whosoever committed sin, transgression also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law.
For sin is the transgression of the law. The sister said, Esau, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. So, God hate then. God hate. So, why is it that we were taught to us in the church that God loved everybody and that we all are God's children?
The children of the world.
And let's watch this. Where's this sister, no? That's a song that. Let me show this now. That was a song that was taught in Christianity. It is not documented in scripture. Romans chapter 9 and verse 13.
The book of Romans chapter 9 verse 13.
Listen to this. This is Romans chapter 9 verse 13. Listen.
As it is written.
It is documented down. You understand? Read.
Jacob have I loved. Who does he love?
logical. Romans chapter 9 verse 13. You understand? God said, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. See? What's this now?
Amos 3 verse 1. Hear the word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
So God has spoken to you against you, the Israelites, read.
And against the whole family which I have brought out of the land of Egypt, saying, you have I know of all the family of the earth.
So of all the nations that are upon the earth, on the face of the earth, God says only you, the Israelite, that he know. Only you alone he know. Read on.
Therefore I will punish you for all your iniquity.
So that is why you're in the condition that you're in. Because God has given you statutes and commandments. Only you alone he knows, therefore he will punish you for all your iniquity. That is why you are facing all these form of disease, the sicknesses that is plaguing you. My brother, my virgin, in either white or yellow. Do you know that you're an Israelite according to the Bible? Come forward, man, come forward. Do you know that you're an Israelite? Come forward, man. You see, very simple now.
Very good.
It's very simple to stand at a far distance in a virgin, but we are your brothers. We're not here because we want to utter our voice. We're here for a purpose, a particular reason. Give me Isaiah chapter 49, verse 6. Right? We're here for a particular reason. We're on a mission. God sent for us on a mission. Very good.
The book of Isaiah 49 and verse 6. And he said, it is a light thing that thou shouldest be my servant to raise up, preserve the preserve of Israel.
Why were we sent to do what?
To raise up the preserve of Israel.
The men of God are sent to raise up the Israelites. We are sent to raise you up. Because what? You are sleeping. Because you don't know your nationality. Because you don't know where you're from. Who you are. You don't even know your God. God said, go forth and raise them up. And that's what we are here to do. To wake you out of the dead state that you're in. You understand me, virgin? Because all people are in a dead state right now. You understand?
The book of Proverbs 21 and verse 16. The man that wandered out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead.
You hear what God said? The man that departs of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. You understand? You get it? Give me Baruch chapter 4. Baruch chapter 4, verse 1. Right? God, is there a reason why God said we are not physically dead, but spiritually we are dead. Our mind is dead. We think that all we can do is just like we want. Just my sister, you know it is a sin for us for you to just implants. You know that? Same thing, because nobody's not telling you these things, sister. It's time for you to hear the word of God and make a change. You hear that, Baruch? Yeah. See that?
The book of Baruch, chapter 4 and verse 1. This is the book of the law. This is the book of the commandments of God and the law that endureth forever.
How long does the Lord endure for?
Endureth forever.
The law endure forever. The law can never be done away with. It is forever.
Read. All they that keep it shall come to life.
Shall what?
Shall come to life.
So if you keep it, you shall come to life. Then if you depart from it, God says you shall remain in the congregation of the dead. Read on.
But such as leave it shall die.
Shall what?
Shall die.
Now that is why we're in the condition that we're in. We have departed from the laws of God. That's why we're in a dead state that we're in. Do you understand me, virgin? Do you understand?
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. And know, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
So now, you know you're an Israelite. The Lord said, no, Israel, what does the Lord your God require of you? Do you accept the fact that you have a God? You acknowledge that. Read on.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk
in all his ways. To fear the Lord, to walk in all his ways with,
and to love him.
To love the Lord with,
and to serve the Lord thy God.
To serve him with,
with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
With what?
With all thy heart and with all thy soul.
All your heart and with all your soul. Are you willing to do that? Well, I'm not done. Hear the word of God. Just give me five more. One more second. 1 second, brother. Read.
13. To keep the commandments of the Lord and his statutes. To keep the commandments of the Lord and his statutes.
To keep the commandments. Do you understand my brethren? You're willing to do that? You're going to get some of the statutes and commandments. Right? Take for example, give me Exodus 20. Get it. Do you buy, you buy these today? Buy them. Okay, you are going to say about that.
Go to Exodus 20 and verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
God said, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Do you know how to keep that Sabbath day holy? How do you keep that Sabbath day holy?
Worshiping from the start, from 6 to 7.
You are going to say about it. Read.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
Is today the seventh day? Is today the seventh day? Yes. God said you have 6 days. You have from Sunday all the way to Friday before sundown to do all your laboring. Read.
In it, thou shalt not do any work.
But the seventh day you should not be doing any work. You understand? Read.
Thou nor thy son, nor thy servant, nor thy cat, thou nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates.
Right, you shouldn't be doing any work on God's Sabbath day. Give me one in Nehemiah. Right? So therefore, you shouldn't be working on God's Sabbath. You understand? We have another law on the Sabbath day that you should not be breaking. Okay? You say you buy this today, right? Let's get that. Right? Is it lawful for you to be buying on God's Sabbath? Huh? So therefore, what you did right now, buying on the Sabbath, do you think you are sinning against your God? You know, I said, yes, you have sinned against your God. Okay, because guess what now? God have given you, Israelite, commandment. You understand? So when we say we love the Lord, and you don't want to walk in God's commandment, you're proving yourself to be a liar. You understand?
Bro.
If you say you love the Lord, and on the Sabbath day you're out here buying and selling, you're showing you to say that you're a liar.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.